Snap-on Training Solutions helps you get the most out of your VERUS Pro diagnostic tool. This training module covers the use of scanner data in graphing view. Live data parameters are some of the most valuable clues to help track down a vehicle fault. Live data is one form of backdoor information, or data that is output from the Vehicle Electronic Control Module, or ECM. A numeric view of parameter ID, or PID data, will not always reveal problems or show relationships between PIDs. Graphing relationships between data parameters gives you a view of performance over time. Data graphing can show momentary failures and data trends over time. Tap the graph button to open a data graph for that parameter. Selecting a parameter for graph view moves it to the top of the list. The graph button switches the live data viewing mode between a numeric view and a graphing display. The graph provides a large number of data points plotted so that you can compare events over time. Multiple graphs allow you to view relationships between components. From 1 to 16 graphs can be displayed on the screen. Scroll down for more data using the touch screen or up-down arrows. All data is continuously being recorded for all available parameters for the selected ECM. Select more parameters to graph if desired. Values above each graph show the current, maximum, and minimum value of captured data. Minimum and maximum values are stored even after the data has scrolled off the screen. Tap to expand the graph to fill the entire screen. Tap again to collapse the graph to the standard view. The Properties button on the scanner toolbar is used to configure certain characteristics of the parameter graph display. Selecting opens a Properties dialog box that allows you to adjust colors, settings, and sweep. The PID trigger is a valuable tool to automatically capture data when a parameter value is outside of normal range. The Set Trigger command sets upper and lower values to start recording a data movie when the signal crosses the set value. This is similar to an OBD2 freeze frame. Up to three parameters at once can have PID triggers. Tap the graph properties icon on the parameter graph you wish to set triggers on. The graph properties dialog box opens. From the graph properties dialog box, tap triggers on. A check mark appears in the box and the min and max fields activate. Tap either max maximum or min minimum to activate that field and open the keyboard. Type the desired trigger value into the field. Tap the other field and enter a trigger value, then close the virtual keyboard. Tap Save to close the dialog box. Trigger lines, blue for upper and red for lower, display on the selected parameter graph. The area between the upper and lower trigger lines establishes the triggering condition. Any data points that register outside of the set trigger conditions initiate a snapshot. To arm the triggers, tap the snapshot icon. The snapshot button changes colors to indicate it has been armed, and any data point outside your set conditions will pause data collection and save a recording. Once triggering is armed, it remains on until you clear or disarm. The zoom options on the data buffer toolbar allow you to change the magnification level of the sweep when viewing data graphs. Use the zoom in plus button to increase magnification and the zoom out minus button to decrease magnification. The Save icon saves the current screen information along with all data stored in the buffer. The recorded data movie is automatically saved. Tap the Data Manager icon on the home screen, select Scanner Data Folder, Choose the data movie you want to see. Use the scroll buttons to scroll forward or back through the collected data. Scroll down to view more data parameters. Snap-on is dedicated to helping you get the most out of your diagnostic tool and keep your customers happy. Click here to watch the next module in this training solutions series. And be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you don't miss the next great product from Snap-on.